G'day guys, Lemon Eating Cal here, and today I'm back with something a little bit different, maybe a little bit of a special video, well, for me anyway. Yesterday I reached 5,000 subscribers. Now, that probably doesn't sound like a lot in the big scheme of YouTube. I mean, like PewDiePie is sitting on about 50 million, so I'm close. But I've still got a little bit to go until I catch that up. Yeah, I just want to say thank you guys for all your support and your comments and your views. It's really made the channel what it is. And I know a lot of that has come off the back, the kind of the hype or the success of Final Fantasy 15. But I like to think my content is good enough to keep you guys coming back. And I've also had, I guess, a bit of luck and a little bit of knowledge on how to work with the YouTube algorithm. So I think 50% of my views now come from suggested videos, which means it's good. It means I'm getting internally promoted within YouTube, and I think 30% of my videos also come from the browse function. So YouTube's been treating me really well. So that's another thing to consider if you're ever thinking about starting a channel. But definitely, it's because of you guys that I have the subs, and I am incredibly thankful for that. So thank you. I wanted to take this opportunity as well to kind of talk again about where the channel's going, I guess. I know I did that a little bit in the New Year's video, but yeah, things have changed slightly. My evaluation of things have changed ever so slightly. So yeah, with Final Fantasy 15, I'm continuing to do content on that. At the moment, I feel I'm kind of running out of ideas of what to cover. There are things that I can still do. I've by no means done the 100% coverage of Final Fantasy 15, but they're not really things that I have a huge interest in, and I don't believe it adds that much to the game. And there's already hundreds of guides out there, and I don't know. I'll only approach a guide if I feel like I can give it a slight tweak, or I can kind of give it my own little flavor. But it's really hard with a lot of the information that's left. But I'll try my best, and we'll see what happens. But I definitely intend to cover, like, I'm going to cover the carnival that's coming up on the 24th of January. So I hope, by the looks of it, it doesn't seem like it's going to be a huge chunk of content. But hopefully I'm wrong. But I'm thinking maybe a couple of hours at most. But yeah, like I said, I really hope I'm wrong. I hope there's a couple days worth in there at least. But yes, I definitely intend to keep supporting Final Fantasy, and they've already announced the episode Gladios that they're working on, so that should be pretty cool. There's a few details come out about that, and yeah, it might be a fun little distraction. So beyond Final Fantasy, I am looking towards the 24th is when I'm really going to start gearing up with new game coverage and guides and maybe walkthroughs. I'll have a look at that. I'm still refining the process. You might have seen I'm doing Kingdom Hearts 1 playthrough. Now, I realize that wasn't the most popular choice that I could have done, but for me, it's a game I really, really love, and I wanted to kind of get my first experience doing that with a game that I liked and I had knowledge about and that I was interested in. I'm not very good at playing it, I will say that, but I do feel like I know the game quite well, so I just wanted to start off on that foot. If you don't like those, by all means, ignore them. I'm fine with that. I know where you guys, most of the base, where their interest lies, so that's fine. Just do me a favor, if you're not interested in the Kingdom Hearts series, don't thumbs down it. I realize you don't like it, but I can see that by the views, so yeah. But if you don't like the way I play or the way I commentate, then by all means, thumbs down. All good. But I get the message, it's not very popular. So, on to other games that I want to play. On the 24th, Yakuza 0 comes out. Pumped for that. I think it'll be really good fun. You can kind of just, for the most part, switch your head off. It does have a good story, but you don't have to think too hard about it. So, yeah, just kick the shit out of people with couches and bicycles, and yeah, it'll be great fun, and hopefully it'll be really good to watch as well. I don't know how it'll go making guides or walkthroughs or anything, but I'll take a look at it and I'll see what I can do with it. But definitely I want to share it with you because I feel like I'm quite excited about it, and I hopefully I can make videos where that excitement comes across to you guys, and you can kind of share it, because that's what I want to do with this with channels. If I'm not sharing knowledge, then I want to share excitement or my enthusiasm for something. And also, I wanted to cover Resident Evil 7. I've talked about this before, but definitely big on my list. I think it's going to be a good hark back to the original Resident Evil. Sorry, nearly said Final Fantasy. I think they're going to try and go back to their roots a little bit, but also spin off in a new type of genre. So I'm quite excited to see what they do with it, and I'm really hoping that they have some cool. Resident Evil usually has really cool bonus content. Once you finish the game, you can get different characters and weapons and kind of fun stuff. So I'm really looking forward to it. Whether I can make guides on it or not, I'll see, but I definitely want to do a walkthrough of it, probably with face cam. So yeah, that'll be good. And then we also have Kingdom Hearts 2.8 coming out on the 24th. I've looked at some of the streaming that's going. There's one guy that streamed pretty much everything there is about the game. I've had a quick look over it. Dream Drop Distance, I must say, I was not very interested in it in the first place. And looking at it now, I can't say I'm hyped for it. It looks okay, but I don't know. I have to get my hands on it and see how I feel. But from as of now, I'm thinking I really don't know how much I can do with it. I'll get my hands on it, I'll see, and I'll let you guys know. But I'm gonna reserve that judgment. I'm not gonna say I'm gonna fully cover it yet. I'll see how it goes. But the Birth by Sleep, or the Prelude to 3, or the one with the girl. Sorry, I sound like a Kingdom Hearts noob. But anyway, the Birth by Sleep, I believe it's called, looks amazing. The combat looks fluid, and the graphics are really good for a Kingdom Hearts game. And the battle system looks great, and it just looks like a whole lot of fun. So I'm definitely going to cover that one. Probably do a walkthrough or a playthrough of that. I think it goes for about 2.5 hours, 3 hours. So it should be a little short, sharp series that should be a bit of fun. And again, I hope my enthusiasm for it comes across. So that's pretty much all coming up in this month, but that's quite a bit of content. I think that's going to cover right through to February easily, very easily. Plus, we got the Final Fantasy stuff there too. So I don't think there's going to be any drought for the next few months at least. Now, the games beyond January that I'm looking at, is the biggest one for me by far is Nioh. That is like the Eastern Samurai type version of Dark Souls, I guess. I am a massive Dark Souls fan. On Steam, I have done the Dark Souls 1, Dark Souls 2, and Dark Souls 3. I've got the 100% achievements for them and all the DLCs. So, yeah, I'm definitely keen on playing Nioh. If it's even three quarters or half the game that Dark Souls is, I'll be pretty excited. I haven't played much of Bloodborne, actually. I've played probably about 50% of it, maybe 75% of it. So that might be something I look at in the future if I'm kind of there's a bit of downtime as well. So let me know if you're interested in that. Also coming up, we've got Zero Horizon. I saw the new clip for it today. It does look cool. I was hoping for like a kind of a Monster Hunter Dragon's Dogma, like climbing over big mechs and stuff and stabbing the crap out of them. It's looking like maybe just from what I picked from the trailer, that maybe there's going to be a bit of stealthiness and more humans involved than I originally thought. But I'll check it out closer to the release. It's one of those games that looks like it has huge promise, but maybe they're promising a little bit too much. So we'll see what happens. Also, Tekken is coming out, which Tekken 7, I think it is, Fated Retribution or something, some name. I used to be a pretty big Tekken fan, and actually I have built my own controller in preparation for it. It uses a Brooks Universal board, so I can play it on any system, PC, whatever. So I built that specifically for Tekken 7. I tried it out a little bit on Street Fighter V, but Street Fighter V, not the best. So I'm waiting on Tekken. Also, Kingdom Hearts 1.5 and 2.5 should be good. But the unfortunate news for this year, it seems like, from what Squaresoft have been saying, Kingdom Hearts 3 and Final Fantasy VII Remake, they are behind schedule and they're thinking there's going to be a delay on it. I don't know how much of a delay, but I really wouldn't be surprised if we don't see it this year. And even if we did, I would be probably expecting it towards the end of the year. But yeah, we'll see how we go on that one. But between definitely now and a few months, I can see a whole heap of content. So it's going to be kick ass. I'm really excited for it. I don't think there's going to be any drought of content. So yeah, I'm pretty hyped up. Let me know what you think about the games coming up, what you're excited for, what you want to see other people playing, what you're going to stream, all that stuff. Just let me know because I want to share the hype. So another thing that I talked about last time was my work injury or my back injury. For those that don't know, I hurt myself at work. I've never done it before. I'm certainly not a person that kind of takes the piss, and I'm usually quite fit and physically able, but this one kind of took me by surprise. So I've been off work for about 3 months now, and that's primarily why I started the YouTube channel. But I went for a checkup today, and it seems like I'm not going to be able to return to work for at least another month, and then after that, we might even consider a form of spinal surgery. So I'm happy and generally healthy. It's just my little back problem there. So it's good and bad news, I suppose. More so bad than good, but it means that I have more time for YouTube. Of course, I have to do my physio and things like that, but otherwise, I'm definitely dedicated to getting more videos out there, and yeah, I'm gonna have the time to do it. So it's quite good. Yeah, what next? Comments. I am going to make a comment on this video, and then I will pin the comment. And if you guys have any questions for me, then leave them there, and I plan on making a follow-up to this video in about 1 or 2 weeks, maybe, depending on the attention that it gets. If it gets a couple of questions, then whatever. I'm gonna make the video anyway, and I'll just answer those questions. So there. Yeah, if you've got any questions about, I don't know how much help I can be in the regards of YouTube, but if I can help you out in any way, if you've got any little questions about starting a small channel or anything, maybe I can help you in with some of the very, very basics. But yeah. Or if you've got any questions about me, what I'm doing, why I'm so amazingly handsome, then just put them in that comment that I pin, and I'll try and get back to them. And also, on the note of communication, I do have the Facebook page. It's still a little bit bare bones. There's not much going on there, but that's only because there's not all that much interaction at the moment. And that is, if you want to check that out, it's just facebook.com/lemoneatingcow with a K, gaming. Yeah, that's pretty much all you do. Or you can just type in at lemoneatingcowgaming and you should be able to find it pretty easy. But I find that's probably the easiest way if you just want to private message me or just send me a message or maybe post something on the wall there. It's probably the easiest way because YouTube sometimes can be a bit, I don't know. I go to post a reply and I'll be this long ass reply and then I'll just say failed to post comment. And it's quite frustrating. So yeah, if you want to chat, then often when I'm editing videos, I have quite a bit of downtime when I'm waiting for uploads and things like that. So if I've got something to, or someone to talk to, or like a little thing to post on, then it's good filler for time. So yeah, hit me up over at Facebook. Or even Reddit, if you're on there, you can find me as the username Lemon Eating Cow Gaming. So yeah, just give me some love over there. But yeah, that's pretty much all I wanted to say. Any questions, like I said, pin it on that comment, and that's about it. So once again, I just want to say thank you, and I'm really happy for the support, and I hope that one day I can be a horrible sellout diva that forgets all his base subscribers. No, that couldn't happen. Well, maybe. But I'll try to avoid it happening. Maybe when I get to 55 million, I might forget a couple of subscribers, maybe. Let's see. Let's see. Yeah, so if you enjoy not exactly this video, maybe it's a bit long-winded, maybe I was just rambling about bullshit. But if you like what I'm doing, please leave a thumbs up. If you got any comments, like I said, pin it on that comment or just, chuck it down there. Say whatever you want, criticisms, praises, whatever. I'm good. Insults. And yeah, if you like what I'm doing and you are keen to see what happens in the future, please subscribe if you haven't already. And once again, thank Moo. This is Lemon Eating Cow.